Hi, I'm Fredrik, creative lead on Amnesia the Bunker. I thought I'd take this opportunity to play through actually the game a bit. I thought I'd play through a version of Shell Shock, you can say, and do some dev commentary on top of that. Hope you're up for it. So I thought instead of just starting a real Shell Shock, I'll actually cheat a bit. So I'm gonna go here and start a Shell Shock mode, but instead of actually setting this to saving cost fuel, I'm gonna do a saving with the default saving. So basically that I have infinite saves, because playing through this and then having to restart now, and that's gonna be horrible. So I'm cheating a bit, but as you can see, the Shell Shock mode with all of the settings here now is very, very difficult, but I hope we'll get through it. I'm playing on a controller, as you can hear, but that should be fine. Let's see, no game pausing hints. I'm not gonna do the intro this time. If you want to play the game, you want to see the intro, you're gonna have to play the game yourself. So I'm starting from when you wake up in the bunker, basically. So here we go, let's do this. I'm gonna see if I can switch this over as well, over to this side, so I don't hide the inventory. So basically, I'm gonna talk through a bit of what our design decisions while we were developing this game for certain areas and things. So try and be as thorough as I can while actually playing the game and avoiding to die. Let's see how that goes. So, of course, first of all, we wake up in the bunker as Henri Clément, French soldier in the World War I. We have amnesia, of course, otherwise, why call it amnesia? So let's see, here we go. Also going to talk through a bit what new things we have in the latest update. We released a big update around Halloween, and some of the things in there are quite new and challenging. For example, we have one thing that I can show you is this, that if you break some boxes, there might be loot inside of them. That was not part of the original version of the game. Maybe it should have been, but it wasn't. So I'm not gonna read through any notes, because we're gonna take it, like, try and do this fairly quickly. If you want to take in the story, I think that's better done on your own. So let's go. So of course, first of all, we find our trusty flashlight. And this flashlight, as many of you know, is a double-edged sword. It gives you infinite light, but it also makes a hell of a lot of noise. So you should be careful when and where you use it, basically. I'm gonna skip the notes, I think. Some of the notes, of course, contain hints for you, so if you're playing the game for the first time, I highly recommend to check out the notes, especially the ones with a red pin on them, because that indicates they have some information of importance that could actually be super important for you to progress. What we also did in this version was that we actually added a bunch of new places where items can spawn, so resources. It's quite difficult even for me now to know that you go to the usual spaces and see if I can find some resources. So all empty up here, seems. Yeah, so playing on Shell Shock mode means also very limited resources, so at least I don't have to worry about fuel for the save lamp, which you would have if you play the Shell Shock mode which is the most difficult mode, apart from you, of course, customizing your own difficulty. Also, you can see here, these doors are made of wood, meaning that the thing that hunts us in this bunker can actually break down these doors. So if you play on easy, normal, or hard mode, then these doors are metal, and they give you a much better shelter than they do in shell shock mode. So the idea with this room, of course, from a game design perspective, is that we wanted this room to be your base. This is where you have everything. You have the save lamp. This is the basically the only place you can save. There is one other place I hope to get to it eventually. But it's where you can save. It's where you have the map over the bunker. We have that over here. You can zoom in and go around. And of course, these areas are abstract. They are not detailed yet. If I find the map pieces for each of these sections, they will become more detailed for me. Currently, only the main hub area, the main bunker, is what's detailed enough for me to take in. So this is where we're at, the administration office. We have the officers' quarters down here, the green area, and then bunch of other rooms around here. What you can also see are these icons over here. So these power icons, they are on shell shock mode. They are indicating if the power is on, in which areas the power is on. It's randomly allocated to one area when you start a shell shock mode playthrough. And this time I got the prison turned on from the beginning. So in order to turn on the other ones, I need to find fuses and put them into the fuse boxes in each of the levels. So this requires me to search for them. Prison is not a good randomization for me. Prison, I would have preferred maybe maintenance or soldiers' quarters to start with, but okay, let's work with this. Of course, in this room, you also have your storage box. Here you can put stuff you don't feel that you need. There's also the possibility to drop things wherever. You can drop things at any point in the game. Oh, grenade. Thank you very much. But that means that they will be located more difficult to find. I mean, putting the stuff in your inventory, in your storage box, is a better way to organize yourself, basically. I think I'll bring that grenade immediately. Down here then, also in direct connection to your base, is the generator room. So here's the generator. Here's the sign that tells you that this need to be on at all times. The fucker hates light. So that means have the generator on as much as possible, otherwise you'll just basically have a harder time with the beast that's hunting you down here. So what you saw here also was a dog tag located on one of these corpses, and I picked it up, and it had a code on the back of it. So part of the game mechanic in this game is that you need to find these dog tags in order to open lockers and in order to open certain doors. Of course, we have the stopwatch as well. Stopwatch is basically something that syncs up with the generator. So if I put this in, let's start the game off with some fuel in the generator. You can see how it automatically brings out this pocket watch and sets it so that I can basically carry it with me and check for how much time I have left on the generator. More fuel, nice. Let's see, anything else? No. So now we need to hurry because this drains quickly on shell shock mode. So basically, we want to get out of here. Need to check the code. The codes are all written down in your inventory in one of the tabs here. So 9714. Another thing with the Was it 97, 14? I hope it was. Let's see. Yes. Another thing, in shell shock mode, the inventory does not pause. So that does not pause the game. When I'm in the inventory here, the game is actually running in the background. On any of the other difficulties, the normal, easy, or hard mode, then that the inventory pauses the game, basically. Gives you a bit more time to react and do whatever you feel is necessary. Then we have these power switches. We should go around and turn them on. Oh, here we have some friends. And we have also a trap here, I think. Yeah, that's a gas grenade sitting on that one. So should probably not trip that yet. Could be a good thing to have for later. Actually gonna put the grenade on a shortcut. A hotkey, sorry. Now I'm picking up the notes anyway, but bottle. So now using the flashlight here is basically I'm risking that the beast hears me and might want to make an entrance or an exit rather from one of these holes. So maybe putting that explosive barrel there could help give me some time. As you can see, loot is very scarce in this. Oh, I shouldn't have said anything. Look, sometimes you just get lucky. And there goes the power. Okay. Already, yeah. As you could hear, the monster seems to have stepped out into the environment. Can't really hear it yet, but probably around here somewhere. Sounds like he's coming this way, or? Oh, fuck. As you can see, I'm getting scared by this game still. What the heck did he do there? Oh my god. He just went through my save room. Okay, we need to turn this back on. Oh man. I played it so many times, this game, and it still gets me. I don't know. That's super fun. Let's see. Good start on this playthrough, I think. I no longer have any doors to my safe room. And also fuel is gonna run out quickly. Man, look, he made a mess. So we need to find those fuses. I mean, the prison is already lit up with power, but could actually go into the prison and see if I bullets. So also, when you're playing on normal, easy, or hard mode, the other modes, let's call them that, then then you'll always get the gun to start with. But in shell shock mode, you need to find the correct locker and the locker code. So what I need to do here now is to get into this room over here, Delisle's room, because he has the dog tag for the locker with the lockdown wheel. Oh, more fuel. I think it sounds like he's in that hole. Let's see if I making too much noise here. Yeah, he's coming out. Oh, this means I'm gonna die as well, right? Did I get him? I actually don't know. Wow, this is starting really well, this. I think I got him. Gives me a bit of time. Not a lot, but a bit of time to act here. Bandages. Also in shell shock mode. It sounds like I've actually damaged the gas canister. Yeah. In shell shock mode, the bandages are extra important because you need to stop the bleeding if you take damage. Let's see, we can pour some fuel over these buggers and give them a grenade too. So by doing this now, I'm burning the corpse that they are feasting on there, which means that they won't respawn around that corpse anymore. But I'm guessing our friend want to check out on that sound over there. I'm gonna save as often as possible here so we don't have to. I should do the same with this one actually. Because we're gonna pause here quite a lot of times. So, okay. We've got the code for the wheel. Let's go to the mission storage. I don't have any more grenades right now. I had to use one in defense and then one to set fire to the corpse. So getting into the mission storage. The mission storage den has a bunch of different lockers, as you can see here. In the lockers, if you find the codes 0994, you will get some goodies. So you can check also. So also here, there are less lockers here in shell shock mode because instead they've been randomly placed out in the environment. Again, on the other modes, you have all of the lockers located here basically. So here you can see G. Travers has the gun in his locker. So we need to find that gun. That code, if we want to get the revolver. I could really use another grenade. I actually feel much safer if I have one of those. There's basically no loot in here. Yeah. When I say that, usually I find something, but not this time. Okay. Need to go. So what we found there was the gas mask. The gas mask, of course, can protect me from gas grenades, gas canisters, which is actually underrated in this game, if you ask me. So I actually think I'm... Oh, man. Walked on a trap. Expecting our friend to have heard that. Oh, just realized I didn't take the wheel. Bear with me here, I'm not that used to streaming and talking at the same time, or recording and talking at the same time. 22 23 23 23, was it? Okay, I got the wheel. Actually a bit curious why the beast didn't show up yet. Made some noise here. Maybe he got hurt by something. Oh, sorry. So with this wheel now, we're opening up all of the sub-levels. So the emergency lockdown is off. But as you can see, also the power went out, so... Did I have some fuel? I have one. Oh. I'm just so used to locking the doors behind me, but it's pointless now. There's another code then. Usually, so basically all of the corpses have dog tags near them. They could be... They can be duds, I mean, without any code on them. But as you probably remember, I did set fire to one of the corpses over here. Let's go and see if we... Man, it's dark over here. Why? Of course, now I'm running a lot, which is also not ideal. Oh, shit. Okay. Better be more quiet. What was the code? Code was 410, but I don't think we had that locker there, so that locker is most likely located somewhere out in the other levels. We have another room over here. Should watch out for that trap. He's been making a mess here. As you can see, this thing over here is broken, and it left some goodies as well. Okay, but there's not that much to pick up at the moment. Maybe I should check down here the wine cellar as well. Oh yeah, I blew up a grenade here, meaning that the lights went out. So the lamps are actually breakables as well in this game. Nothing? Man. Okay. I'm thinking prison might be a good place to go now. Go instead of running, maybe. But the power is gonna die on me anytime now, so I'm gonna do this in the dark. And I have nothing. Oh, hell no. I have nothing to protect, to defend myself with. He's in that hole. So, going into the prison then. So as you can see, the game, like, the whole design is basically focused around the noise. The noise you make, the actions you make, and how that affects the monster. And of course the generator and the light, because he becomes so much more active. So this is one of the fuse boxes in Shellshock mode, so as you can see here, it's actually already a fuse in that one. That one is locked, that one is locked. This one is not locked. Even those kind of things make noise, so you need to be real careful. Oof. Fuel, and what's that? Oh, bottle. I don't think I need a bottle. It's not a bad idea to put these over the holes, because if he breaks them, then we... Oh. Then we might actually get some goodies out of it. So this door over here is one that we need to break. But that will attract him. He's coming, I think. So, okay, back to the base. Back to the base and save. Don't remember really what we had here. I mean, don't need two bandages, I hope. Won't pick up that one. Did we have only one fuel? Oh man. I'm thinking now, so this is the kind of way we want this game to play out. You gotta be strategizing in this area. So I'm thinking maybe maybe I should go dark. No, I'll actually put this fuel in because that will give me some time at least. Hopefully it should give me some time if I don't make too much noise running over there, but some time to go into the prison and maybe loot a bit. See if we can. I opened up this door over here, broke down the wooden door, so that means we should be able to get into a few more rooms and see if we can find some stuff. Hopefully, for example, a fuse. Over there we have the cells. Oh, look, no rats. Ah, that's a shame. Need to also double check these, because if they had a red cross, then it means they are booby trapped. Let's see, we have some lockers in here actually. What lockers are that? Voucher? We don't have voucher's code. Boucher is probably the name. I have to say I'm sorry for the my French pronunciation. So in this level we want to get into the guard room over here. Oh, what's that? Meat. That might be useful actually, especially playing in shell shock mode when resources are so scarce. You really want the you can really make use of things like meat to keep rats away. Over here we have a German prisoner with some cutters. We need to get into that room, but it also means we need to get into this room to open the doors, and they need the power to be on. It's a shame I can't find. Let's do this. Let's hope I don't die now. I'm thinking that the power will go out anytime. Oh, getting stuck on the wall. Oh, where did it go? Can't see anything. Oh man. Oh, he's gonna come out of there. And there goes the fuel. Oh man. Ah, oh, nothing of use. Just need to wait. Oh, he's getting closer. And the power is out, so he might be sticking around. Oh, he's coming in here. Can't see shit. Actually, sorry, I'm gonna raise the gamma slightly. Not because I want to see in the dark, but because it's too dark for me. Need to at least see the floor in front of me. So you can hear the heart rate. It's kind of an indicator of how close he is. It's just outside the door. Checking for me. Problem now is knowing, he's been turning this place upside down as well. Okay. Oh, fuck! This is not ending well, is it? Ah, shit. I'm screwed. I thought it was the other way in the other areas. Also with shell shock mode and with hard mode now, with the new Halloween update, there's a setting called Stalker Unpredictability. Increased Stalker Unpredictability. And he's just here. Oh man, he was just waiting for me. I'm screwed. I'm dead. He was waiting for me. So the unpredictability works even for game devs. All right, it's tough. So, but I know, at least now we know that we can't find any fuses in the prison. So maybe we have to just actually then take on another area in the dark. And I think the soldiers' quarters could be a good place to go. Because usually the soldiers' quarters is it is quite a big area, and it has quite a lot of loot usually, so let's hope that it does also now. Let's see. Yes, thank you very much. Fuel is one of the most precious resources in the game, if you ask me. So with the game, we went for an immersive sim approach in a way. We want the player really to have... that's a grenade. If I could jump this, pour some fuel over them, and then trigger the grenade, we can actually... Yeah. Let's do this. So, I was saying, the immersive sim approach where we want... Oh, he's coming this way now, so I can't talk and play at the same time, by the look of things. Yeah, so we put that on fire. Let's not... But let's trigger that one, and let's put this on. This should keep us safe. He's here. Just hope he's not gonna wait me out. He's close. Don't know how long the gas will last. I really wanna... Oh shit, he's seeing me. I have no clue where he is. Run, 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 run. It's dark. It's too dark. Oof. Oh shit. Actually, would be nice if he came this way. Can we get him to come this way? He likes banging shit up, so... Don't really have anything to throw or attract him either. So... As much player agency as possible, just let you, the player, decide how to handle... Okay, come here, big boy, let's try this. And stay away from the... He's not following? I'm just standing here with a fuel can. Breaking down doors. I don't really know where he is. I really want to make some noise here. Oh, physics. Love it. Seems to have decided to take a stroll to a different area in here. That means we can start looting. I wouldn't mind finding one of those fuses now. Oh, here we go. Let's drop that. This means we should probably go back and save. Oh yeah. Okay. So let's go back. Let's put that down. It looks silly walking around. Come here, I'll throw a can of fuel on you. I think we're doing good here, actually. Oh, I shouldn't have said that. He came out somewhere. Not sure where. Thank you. So the gas mask kind of saved me. After a while, he saw me and wanted to attack, but so this generator room is basically also your panic room. It's kind of nice. Just did I check this one, by the way? I must have. Put more fuel in. Actually, yeah, I actually think we need to put two of them, both of them in. So now we have a fuse. That means I kind of think we should go to the maintenance. We should save. Oh, nearly forgot that. Thought I was playing on shell shocked. Ah, need to move fast. Quick, quick, quick. So going into the maintenance, finding the fuse box, turning on the light would be nice. Some people are saying that doesn't really. Yeah, whenever you pick one of these up or check one of these, then it's added to the administration office. You can check them there. Oh, I forgot the. Oh man, I forgot the. The fuse! This is not good, man. Not good. I'm making a dash for it. Let's see what happens. Made some slight progress, so might as well save. Some people are saying this is a horror imsim. Really happy to hear that, actually, because that's the kind of approach we wanted to take, where the options are many for you to do, to act how you want to, but there's still enough of the dynamics in the game for it to be interesting and to create certain situations for you that are different every time, like the generator dying on you at certain points, or you triggering a trap somewhere, or you having to break down a door. So let's see. I would like to break that one, but throwing it into the wall can surely attract the monster as well. Gas grenade. Well, I take that. I actually think I can drop this. But I'm actually gonna put this in the way in case he decides to make an appearance. No loot. Bandage. As you can see now, with the fuse in, we have power in this area, meaning we have a bit of respite. Some people, oh, shit, he's behind me. Ah, oh, there was a gas grenade and a grenade over there. So, takes time to wait him out. Let's play hardball. Yay. You know, when he's sitting in a hole like that, it can easily grab you and pull you into the hole, so it's not a good idea to move close to that one. This might be a good idea though. I love the explosive barrels. People aren't making enough use of them from the playthroughs I've seen. I mean, the monster just breaks everything in its path, and explosive barrels are kind of super useful because it'll make him kind of explode. And what was that? Oh, that was Boucher. Wasn't that in... That locker was in the prison, right? Oh, here we go again. That's a fuel bottle. Another fuse! Hell yeah. Bigger inventory. There we go. He decided to bang on the explosive barrel. Not a good idea, bro. Shit happens when you go about it like that. Okay, let's see. This gives me some time. Ooh. Can't get in here now, can I? I need to throw a grenade. I don't want to do that. Might need that over here. Should we try and get through this? So over here we have a rat tunnel. It's just like basically this level is about the rats. Oh, more fuel. Got so much fuel. But now I'm shell-shocked. When the corpses are randomized, or shell-shocked, it's actually a new game plus, more of a new game plus functionality. Then when the corpses are randomized, then this rat tunnel that is usually has three corpses in it now only had one. Another fuel. Okay, we got all. I need to remember where it's located now. I have fuel here as well, all the goodies that I... Oh. More explosive barrels. Let's see. In case it tries to come up behind me. What should I do? Is it gonna be the gas grenade, or should I actually take some damage from them? No. Oh, it's gonna have to be the gas grenade. On with the gas mask. Oh, the friend is over here. A traverse! That's the gun! I like that. So here's the pillbox. So. I don't want to die now. It's okay. I think I need to use this one. Yeah. Oh, he's behind me. Oh, fuck. He was not behind me. He saw me through the... Oh, whatever it's called. The grating. No, the... Oh, shit, man. Yeah, as you can see, the game just switches it up continuously, even for me. Okay. Now I have the fuse, at least. Let's go do this. I didn't have any meat. Where did I put the meat, by the way? What's... Okay. It's a bit strange, isn't it? Thought I had meat. Did I throw it? Oh man, I'm getting stressed out. I think it also because I'm streaming this to you guys and then don't want to die, don't want to have to replay. But of course, that's how the game goes. So let's see, we need to, oh, need to go put this in. Don't remember what I found here. Was there anything of use? Remember finding grenades and gas grenades and shit. Where did I find those? And I remember putting this over here. I think maybe it's in this box. No. In the locker maybe? Ah, the gas grenade. Lovely. Let's use the same strat because it seemed to work quite well last time, right? Butcher. Butcher. I gotta grab this one. And then another fuse over here, if I don't remember incorrectly, and I did not. Okay. Let's go. Fuel is burning out. Few. I got a few bottles already in two. Only one guy. Do I need to have to use? Okay, there are two now. This was this traverses, yeah. More rats, more codes. Oh shit! Actually, if I get in there, no. Okay. So he saw me through these. And then I ran here. And then he met me in the stairs. Oh shit, okay, yeah. I wish I had more fuel though, but I think I had. The fuck? Okay. Sorry for the language. Oh, he's gone. Back into the hole with ya. So back here again, gonna fuel up, also using the fuel bottle. Of course you can grab the empty bottles and put fuel in them, and if you, oh, it's flickering over there, I'm not going that way. Gas grenade is all I've got. Maybe I should. No, I should do this. Hurry, hurry, hurry. And I should save. I forget to save all the time. So in shell shock mode, I don't know. I don't remember if I told you, but in shell shock mode, you have the bandages. The bandages only stop the bleeding. If you continue to bleed, you'll lose health. So in order to restore health, you need to use medkits. In the other difficulties, that is not the case. Then you can use bandages to heal as well. You don't heal fully with bandages, but at least there's no bleeding mechanism. Apart from you bleeding and leaving a trail, then that can be sniffed by the rats, for example. And if the rats come after you, they're gonna make noise, and that means they might actually attract the monster to you as well. Jesus. Do we have anything here, perhaps? No. Nothing. I'm going the long way around again. Ah, that's not good. We should go this way. So he came out, but where? Stepping too close to the rats, having them wheeze at you is also not a good idea, because that means the monster can get attracted to them, to you. I think his dog tag should be in here, right? Oh yeah, I just remember I had it. Didn't I have Traverse's dog tag now as well? Yeah. Should have grabbed the gun. Not thinking clearly. Oh! My trap worked. I don't know where, but somewhere. He seems to have broken an explosive barrel. Oh, and another one. Oh man, could have. So here also for shell shock mode is a lock. You need to find person named Millard's dog tag in order to open it. If we're lucky, it's over here. No, you rolled. That is actually the code for the lighter. So if we find the lighter locker somewhere, if it wasn't in the mission storage, then do I even have any? I have no. Millard. This means more fuel for us. I need to move slowly here though. So that place is not a good place. That's basically the lair, the beast's lair. That's where he's doing all of his funky stuff with corpses. Oh no, this was rigged as well. Maybe I should actually do this then. Let's see, I need to be clever here. I don't have any weapons at all in this door. Here's the key to the pillbox. Oops. Let's hurry up. Medkit, nice. Would have loved to have a grenade or something to blow that up now. Don't think I have, right? So going up here to find, so this, if you were to play this like you're supposed to, then you need to know about these things through notes that you find. So knowing that. Oh, what's wrong here? There's some. Oh, okay. Knowing that this foreman, Stafford, is going to the pillbox. But unfortunately, he got shot in the eye, meaning that he's no longer with us. But we got his code to his locker, and in his locker is a wrench that we need in order to get into the prison. The guard room in the prison. Oh, our friend is here. And as I said, nothing of use. Sniper. Gonna show you a little trick. Let's see. Come on. I'm here. Missed me. You can do it. No? Don't wanna? Okay. I'm not giving up. Ah. I moved just as he shot. I think our friend went into the holes again. I hope our friend went into the hole again. Oh no, he didn't. He's in that hole. Ooh, ooh, ooh. They are leaving. Hurry up. No code. Okay. You don't want to get close to the codes or the corpses when the rats are there, so. Man. Please don't come out now. Okay. So as I said, this whole level is mostly about the rats. There's so much. Oh, yeah. So many rats in the maintenance. The prison is more about how to handle, basically how to handle the prisoner. It's a very small level compared to the others. Oh, there goes the power. Oh man, I need to actually go run back. Too much progress. Would hate to actually die here. Need to be more careful than I was earlier, just run into him with this new unpredictability update. That's easily done. Oh, I want to save now. Here we go. Thank you very much. So, no fuel, but tons of codes. Oh yeah, hell yeah. That's a lot of coats. Let's go. It's Christmas time. Did I have Bardan? Bardan. Nope. That's pretty much the only one I didn't have, or Stafford, 69-65. So the wrench. Now we can go to the prison. Yeah. Oh, this is good stuff. We get Traverse 92-34. Clement, our own locker, basically, 88-66. And of course, in this game, you need to hold down reload in order to check how much ammo you have, and in order to load. Also in Shellshock mode, the gun is pretty poor defense against the beast, actually. You can shoot him, you can stun him, basically, but not more than that. What do I need here? So we're gonna do prison now to get the cutters. But we need fuel. So we need fuel. So we actually need to go back. Did I say? We need to go back to the maintenance. I think that's where we can find most fuel. So let's go there. Let's hope he doesn't stop us. So it's dark all over the place now. He's gonna be much more active. Oh! Thank you very much. Another one of my traps. That's nice. Nice of him. Well, now we're running out of explosive barrels though. What the heck? Yeah, okay, he's just... I hope he's going away. Yeah, he is. But let's go here, and we actually need to trigger this grenade. Millard, 82-25. Oh, run. Also, actually, the grenades have a longer radius on shell shock mode. So I'll turn on the light a bit here. Oh, what am I doing? I need to go here and fill those up. And that was already full, so let's do that one. And that one. Maybe should have dropped the... I shouldn't have brought the wrench. But anyway, I can make use of the wrench. Need to really watch out for traps now. So we got fuel. Oh, he's gone berserk here. Maybe find some goodies. No, did I break that one when I threw it? That was way too easy. Okay. Actually, I'm gonna do this here. Thank you. So this is the munition storage. Let's hide up here for a moment. Munition storage often has quite a lot of goodies in it. He's not coming? Last famous words. Oh, yes, Forta. We had Forta. 38, 42. I need more space in my inventory. Did I say 42? Yes. Here we go. Shotgun. But what to take out? I'm dropping the... Oh, more grenades. The munition storage is full of... Oh! That sounds like he's on his way here. He's over there, right? Oh, shit, I see. Oh, here we go. Got him. Okay. That means I have another slot in my inventory. What's he doing? I'm deaf. Here we go. Now they bring me the meat. Okay. Really could use. Really could use some more some shotgun shells. So this means we pretty much got this area covered now. I know there's some more fuel in a place, and darkness. So basically, this game isn't really holding your hands in a way. It's just telling you some stuff, and you need to put everything together yourself. That's kind of how we wanted it to be this time, to give you the feeling of actually accomplishing stuff. I know there's a bunch of players that play the game, like in our community, that's played the game quite a lot and still are finding out small tricks and things they didn't know about, so... which is really nice and what we were hoping for, to be honest. Yeah, so I had to take a break there. This PC is not really optimized for recording these long videos, I guess. So, took a short break. Was nice, actually. Could stretch my legs a bit and hydrate. But we're heading over to the prison, I think. That's where we're going. Because we need to get into the control room with the doors so that we can open the cell doors and get the cutters. I also think we had a locker somewhere here. Let's see. Where was that? Over here, maybe? Oh yeah. Ooh. 5528. Oh. Don't come out now, please. Oh. Inventory upgrade. Thank you very much. Did we check this? Ah yeah. I think we checked it and then I died. So now we have the wrench. We can open this grating. Ooh, it sounds like he's on his way here. Let's see, we need to move some stuff out of the way. He's been going berserk here. Actually, I saw a flare on... Oh, another flare there. What's he doing? Well, he tried to go out through a hole. Oh, no. I can't blow this up if he comes in here. That's at least a way to use the gun, even though it might not be the best. And actually two flares, so we haven't seen flares up until now. And I've been playing for like a couple of hours or an hour, hour and a half. I don't know. Time flies when you're having fun. Okay, let's see. So this cell is the cell with the German prisoner. But if I open that up, he's gonna die. But see if I can save him, actually. Maybe I'm gonna blow up the... That was... skill, yo. Back and close. Close the door. Not doing any war crimes here. it's a bit risky throwing that grenade over there. Didn't I bring my... No, I didn't bring the gas mask, okay. Just gonna check. Oh shit, he's over there. You. Maybe we're done here. Got the cutters. And since we got the cutters, that means... Oh, no, don't come here. Oh, he's coming out, right? Another fuse. Did I have? I had fuses enough, right? Sounded like he came out of... Yeah, it's flickering as hell over here. Yeah, I'm not going down there again. Okay. I hope we had enough fuses. Actually unsure now. Took a break and then I forgot everything. Getting too old. Oh, let's see. That was nice. Managed to actually keep the German guy alive. So the flares are also kind of nice to have if you want to set fuel on fire. Where are we heading now? I think we're heading into... Yeah, we're heading into the arsenal. No, the soldiers' quarters next. So... We need the fuse for that. I'm gonna put another fuel in here. Soldiers' quarters. Big area, lots of bunk beds. Oh shit! Oh no, 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 no. It's okay. I'm gonna run. No, I'm. This is the first time I got injured, or. Yeah, so as you can see now that I'm bleeding, if I'm holding down this to check my health, you can see the icon for bleeding. This means that I'm losing health continuously. If I don't use a bandage. But this, I'm gonna stay here actually to be safe. But this means I dropped the med kit. Way into the maintenance area, I think, so I can't restore health. But there was there a med kit? Was there a med kit in the prison? I'm really bad at this game. Probably best to bring two of those, actually. I'm actually bringing... Oh! Gas. He must have... yeah, he triggered a trap near the... Near the rats, or did I? No, he triggered a trap. That's good, so... Maybe he... Got some of the gas and decided to stay away for a while. Power more for the soldiers' quarters. Thank you. And my trap is still here. Would have loved to get into that one, but yeah. He's been going through these doors here, so another photo. I'll leave all of the photos, all of the notes, basically for you to explore yourself. If you haven't played the game already, that is. I'm getting some lag here. I think it's my PC can't really handle the recording and the game at the same time, which is a shame. Turn on that switch, which is important because the switch came out of this hole and leads up into that room where I need to go and by there. Okay. I need to get into the communications room, which is basically in there, and I need the power to be connected all the way into that room. I brought grenades. Let's do this. Pretty damn good view over there. He went to check out the grenade, the explosion. Hope he's gonna piss off after that. But you can never be too sure. Oh, here goes the power as well. Okay. Just gonna go in. So I need to get into the communications room. It's over here, it's locked, has a key, needs a key. And I'm walking over here. What I broke down was the security area. And on this note, it says that also actually a random guy every time. Casal says that he has the key in his bunk bed. So now I need to find Casal's bunk bed. And I don't remember where that is. There is actually a small photo in that first room in the level where you can find, where you can see all of the bunk beds with all the names, so you don't have to go around doing what I'm doing now. But I mean, I'm gonna do it this way now. Was that? That is Casal. Oh, yes. Thank you very much. So, but now we don't have any power. I have two cans of fuel. I can unlock this for now. Maybe check if there's more fuel here. Oh, medkit. Actually gonna use that to heal up when I'm back at the admin office. Another flare. flares are coming late this time around. Oh! He went into my trap. So as you can see, so what you learn from one of the notes is that the power in here is daisy chained, so you need to kind of hook everything up. And as you can see, you follow this here and into this room where I went to turn that switch. So we have power to the communications room. Now I need to go back. Since he blew up that explosive barrel, I'm hoping he's kind of licking his wounds for a while. Has he been walking here? I think I pulled this out before so I could use that door, but yeah, who knows? Unpredictable monster. So okay, heal up with the medkit. Oh, I always forget which side this door is on and what's going on here. Something blocking me? That would be horrible if the monster was after me. Okay. Get all of that health back. So as you can see, this game is all about the generator, the kind of gameplay with the, where the generator plays a part as a dynamic kind of element, that when it goes out, which is up to you, when it goes out, it puts you in a bit of a pickle. And it can happen at any time. And the monster is already so dynamic on its own, so it all creates just these tons of these small dynamic moments. So back and into the communications room, where one of the officers told us that he would broadcast the code for the arsenal. So basically, so the game, the game's goal is very basic. It's you need to blow up the exit. The officers have blown the exits shut after you, after they left. They wanted to seal the beast down here. Now you need dynamite and you need a trigger, a handle for the explosives trigger. That's what you're going for. So reading the notes, you'll get clues and hints on where to find these things. And I've just skipped that now, so giving you a sense of how the gameplay is instead, and just trying to make this as quickly as possible, not stressing it too much. There we have the code for the arsenal. I hate when these places go dark. Can't see if he's... Oh, did he go in here? Must have... Oh no, he blew up the... He broke that... So here you can see the photo with all of the bunk beds I was telling you about earlier. So all of the photos are also... Not all of them, but... Quite a lot of them have important hints as well. A hole in here as well now. Now we don't have any fuel, right? Ugh. So I'm just wondering if we should make what's called a fuel run in this game, I guess. Over to the maintenance and to the fuel storage. I think I'll do that. Otherwise I'll have a hard time finishing this, and we also need to kind of get rid of those rats going into the arsenal. Man, where did it come out from? Over here, I guess. I just realized we need, if we're gonna make a few run, actually need to go down here and use the wrench, because I didn't bring the cutters. But there's two ways to get into this wine storage. So wine storage is basically infinite empty bottles. So if you want to make one of these few runs, oh, another med kit, I take that, thank you very much. So, but perhaps I need to drop some stuff. Need to remember, go back here after the fuel run. I wonder if he's camping out here now. Nope. Thank God. Starting to feel the stress coming on again. The flickering that you hear is kind of disturbing, because lights flicker around the monster basically. Oh no, don't lure him here, please. Damn rats. Oh, I'm so stupid. I didn't bring the bottles, but anyway, okay. There's actually another one here, right? Did I go into the wine cellar, find the med kit, and then forget to bring the bottles? Oh. If you're an experienced player watching this, you'll go like, what's he doing? It's a bit late here as well. I will have to kind of... Oh no, where is he? I think he's just outside. This might be completely stupid. Did he go down here? I have no clue where he is. Oh yes, here we go. I'm screwed. I'll trigger this on purpose. Oh, let's go to the pillbox then. Ooh. Yeah, I'm getting some lag again. It's not the game lagging though. It is my PC. no flickering light out there. Oh yeah, there's flickering light. Oh no. Let's try this. This just stuns him though. He's after me. Oh! I think I might have done this, yeah. Let's think. Us in the team having to endure all of the testing of this game, and I'm still this kind of stressed out. Some people in the team though, they are not as easily spooked as me. Some seem to have nerves of steel. Anyway, I live here now. I won't be using all of these because I want to use one on Did I have a flare left now? No. I dropped those. Do I have one up in? Oh, I should say, by the way, save. Yes! Just need to make sure I hit the damn target with this one. Okay, let's do this. Need to burn this corpse. Oh, come on. Am I standing just next to a hole as well? Yeah, here we go. Time to go back. We're just putting this plan on hold for a while. Oh, I'm back. I'm just peeking out of my little window here. Actually, now we can turn this on. Maybe get him to take a hike. Just need to make sure that this flare ignites. Yeah. Skills. Oh, I miss my metal doors. So as you can be quite creative with fire. So even if I didn't have a... I could actually use the gun as well. I just forgot about that. I could have fired the gun at the fuel. But, I mean, flares are good for this. Okay. We need to go. But now he's camping in the hole, or...? I don't want to get pushed over by him. Oh. He's coming out. No? I thought it was coming out there. Let's see if we can do this. Need to act quite quickly here. So, let's see if we can get him to move over to this hole. Nope. Okay. So as you can see, he still can come out when the lights is on, especially on shell shock mode like this. He doesn't like it terribly much, but oh shit, he's coming this way. Here we go. Oh, this is just burning fuel for me now. I'm gonna go here, I'm gonna lock it. I'm gonna turn off the generator and wait him out. Oh, that wasn't intentional. Hiding behind a beam. Some water, I think, could be good. Have I loaded all of the bullets in the gun? Yeah, 4 left. Now let's go. Actually need to take better care of my inventory, so I'll just quickly drop this off. This could be useful, this could be useful. Yeah, let's do this. Oh, yeah, you know what will be useful? This one. If you check this photo here. No, I don't have that photo, but there's one photo kind of hinting on you being able to use the cutters to disarm traps. Hang on, I don't have a fuse, right? Oh, I don't have a fuse. Where did I find tons of fuses? That was in the soldiers' quarters, right? I hope it was. Stay like on top of things, remember where things are. Bullets. Oh no, hell no. Maybe it was over here actually. It was fairly late in the soldier when I was completing the soldiers' quarters area. Not here. Could have been in the prison as well. Ton of shit over here. It's mostly few flares. Oh wow. Some weird stuff has been going on in here. Watch out for the traps. There's one over there. Refuse the fuse. I need the fuse. I must look for it. And I don't remember where it was. I wish I had a chat here now so it could tell me where it was. Grenade. Thank you. Oof. Girard. 1053. That's the lighter, so with the lighter we can actually craft some stuff. I need fuel badly, so I'll drop this again. Grenades are like my favorite thing playing on this difficulty. I don't even remember where the fuse were that we found. Oh. Not in here, of course. Oh, hell no. No, missed him. Okay, anyway. It wasn't this way, so... and I saved just before this, so... gonna head... over to prison. See if we can find a fuse there. Yeah, yeah, come on. Just gonna make a mad dash for this actually. So as you can see, the lag is coming back a bit for me here. It seems to be going away after a while. There's the fuse. Okay, bye bye. Okay, I think I might... I'll go back and see if it's only this area that's causing me the issues. Almost thought he'd grab me there. Didn't. Thank you for that. There we go again. So now we got the fuse, and I did burn the corpse, right? Yes, so let's try this. Let's see if I'm starting to get lag again here now. Hope not. Did I bring the cutters? I did not. Nope. I actually... Oh! Oh, gas. Stick. And I also don't have the... Oh, here's the fuse box. I'll put that in as soon as I... Can I hear him scrambling about? I didn't get the lighter either. Okay. So that goes out, that goes in, maybe that one as well. So here you go, let's do some crafting, let's do that, but off. Yeah, I didn't have that. I didn't have the lighter, so it's pointless to bring a torch. So now we're heading into the arsenal, one of my favorite levels, maybe the favorite, because I like the break. It's such a... it's a big area, but it's kind of maze-like. But it has a lot of breakable stuff in it, so either you or the monster can actually open up paths. Either you by using explosives like grenades or explosive barrels. So this is why I brought the cutters now. I need to put this on a This means that these become actually items you can pick up. So the arsenal code, we got that from the radio, 8303. Yeah, I'm actually thinking I might have to take a small pause again just to see if the lag goes away, because it's a bit laggy again. I thought my PC would actually stomach this, but I don't need that one. Now I definitely don't need that one, because it's all of the... oh no. So what do I have? I have no gas nades. How do I get past these buggers? Or do I not get past them at all? So everything that's made out of wood basically can be broken. So I can make a path here by blowing this up. That's what I like about this level. Oh, and I walked on that trap, of course. No more fuel around? It's a shame. Oh, there's one more. So I can actually go back and put these two in. Maybe even find a third one, if I'm lucky. There's so little resources on shell shock mode. Oh, that one I would love to have. Was there any brick I could use here instead? I hate the sound of him coming this way. I have flies in my face. Okay, I'm going in here to hide. So this route is down to the Roman tunnels. Again, something you'd find out if you read the notes. And that's where the... that's where the trigger, the handle for the trigger is located. So I need to go down there. Okay. I had more nades, I hope. So let's use this one and then go back to camp. Back to base, rather. It's not in there, I hope. I mean, did I have two fuel cans? Gonna grab me. He's after me. I'm running too much. I know I'm running too much. Oh, there's a brick inside here. That's pretty point useless to me here. Is he coming after me? Oh, yes. Can I go in here and hide again? Seems like it's over here that my PC can't really handle. So this was the area I broke down with a grenade earlier. These buggers. What's that noise? It's a brick in there as well? Oh, here we go. Oh, Claire, 0952. Just next to a hole, thanks for that. I'm skipping so many. So many medkits. Thank you. Thank you again. No rats. Oh, lucky me. So I'm all over here into this place now. Here's where the dynamite is located. Oh, it's lagging badly now. Sorry about that if you're watching. But I can't. Could perhaps take a break again. But I think it's gonna be just the same. Actually, he could, would be nice if he made an appearance here actually. Come on, guy. You can do it. Come on. have nothing to throw at him. Would like to hit two birds with one stone, basically, if he's coming here. Could blow him up and the door. But he doesn't see. Oh! There we go. Okay, don't fuck this up now, please. I'll go away. Am I standing against the wall? Yes, I am. He became quite angry and might have opened up some new paths. By the sound of it, he's done that. Was that nothing in here? That was really not nice. Ah, small damn meat. So I'm taking it just for the sake of it. Look, he's breaking shit again. He's such an angry little friend. You can see he's, oh no, that sounds like he's coming back again. Need to work quickly. Where is he? I have no clue where he is. Over there. I'm gonna run straight into him again. Oh, stay away, please. No. I made a... Okay. That's why I got the meat. Now they focus on the meat, and I can run. Hopefully not straight into the arms of... Yes, thank you. So we got the dynamite. Just need to go back and save, by the way. That doesn't look good. Smoke. When smoke comes out of a hole, that's a bad sign. Okay. So we saved. We got 3 fuel cans. That means we're putting... So now we need to go to the Roman tunnels. The Roman tunnels are basically... back to the arsenal and then down into the water field area. But I know I need to operate the pump there, so I need fuel. I'm putting everything in. Maybe that was stupid, but okay. It's done. Done is done. The cutters, I needed those as well in order to go down here, so otherwise I can't enter this place. Oh, there we go. So there's the pump, but if you follow these power lines, you'll see that it leads over to this switch that is off. Now it's on, and this is where you want to go down. And this thing is floating and you can't push it down, so that's why I need to pump out the water. Actually, I'm gonna try this. Maybe set this down to medium. See if the... game's not gonna look as good, but might not get as much lag anymore. So Roman tunnels, here we go. Should have tested that earlier actually, if that solves it. So for those who have been watching all the way through this playthrough, I was talking about the save lamp, another save lamp in the beginning, and that's the one. And we have some eyeballs. Need to do this every time I get here for some reason. So here you can see that handle that you're looking for, and now you need to go find that and get into some floaty rocks and weird shit going on down here. And we have company. It all gets lost in a terrible twirl. We're actually coming to what person we're hearing is the one who those eyeballs were belonging to previously. As you can see, there are this gas is giving you hallucinations. So here I stay down on my... Shit. Oh man, I'm too easily scared. What did he fire at? Okay, so he's blind then, as since he doesn't have any. It all gets lost. Did I miss the first shot or did I get him? I didn't get him. Well, I should have had my shotgun now. Oh shit. That was a shadow. Oh man, I played it so many times, but I can still not. That's him. Yeah, so I can't pick up this shotgun now since I already have one. Or? Yeah. Just gotta check so that actually I have. Yeah, everything seems to be running and working. Okay, so our friend Toussaint is dead. He's probably better off that way. more inventory space. There is actually another interesting area here. I'm gonna go for that. I think I need to do that. So this whole area is kind of like a little boss fight. It takes you out of the regular gameplay, this area with Toussaint and his shotgun. And the first time you play the game, you can't find the shotgun until you actually, if you kill him. So that's finding it in the locker is a new game plus feature, basically. Also, I think it's interesting, I need to tell this, it's a bit of a spoiler here, so anyone who doesn't want to know too much about the origins of the monster or the story, then maybe you want to tune out until I've gone in here from this place. But so basically the game comes down to, if you read the notes, you start understanding that your friend Lambert, which you should have seen in the intro, if I had played the intro, is actually the monster, and he turned into the monster after you fed him this water. And he bought this little stuffed rabbit here that for his son. And if you put all of these pieces together, we wanted like a reward for people taking in the story, basically, that this little toy rabbit can actually have a use for you in the end game. So I'm not going to say more than that for now. So if you tuned out because you didn't want spoilers, you can come back in again. Still a bit of lag. Oh, I need to find my way out again. And it's over here. Man, I was jumping when he fired his gun. I don't wanna, didn't wanna die again here and have to replay this right now. So here we go, here we go, here we go. Jump, 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 jump. Okay, we're heading back out of the fog. Just a cloth, yes. Anyway, I might need another cloth. I have a lot of inventory space. Guess it's... Let me also test this. Do we had... maybe it's this, actually. Ah. Let's keep it. Hope my PC won't choke on me now, just in the end game here, because now we have everything we need. We can go set up the dynamite. Oh, I didn't save over there, did I? No, I didn't. Anyway, I doubt that he's around here now. Should have heard him. Okay, so we have the dynamite, we have the handle. Medkit could be useful. We don't really have much weaponry. I have a gas grenade. I think I will have to go and make... So, okay. Oh, did I? Yeah. So putting down the trigger here. These are basically the two things you have been looking for throughout the whole game. Dynamite and a hand. And so the whole thing now, or getting in closer to the end game, is that we wanted basically... Oh, he's coming here. Maybe I can go and trigger this. Yeah. So here we wanted the end game to basically be as much of an the situation where you had to use all of the skills that you've learned throughout the game to really to overcome the ending, because as you can see, I didn't manage to blow myself out of this area. Instead, what happened was that, oh, I could have grabbed that one if I would have had been quick. Anyway, so you're getting down into an area where you need to, let's say, fight off the monster. What do I have? But I'm now actually thinking that in order to get the ending that I'm looking for here, I think I wanna go for another fuel run. Can I make it? So going in here. So what I basically want to do is craft Molotov cocktails, but I just realized I didn't get the lighter, did I? No, the lighter, I died after I got the lighter, so... Yeah, Giraud's hasn't been used. Oh, where did I find the light? Oh no. Okay. So as you can see, now I have a big inventory. I can really make use of this. Oh, and here it comes. He's so fast on... I managed to get away from him, I think. And it's so dark. Come on. Traveling through the walls. That's cheating. Okay, so I actually got the... fuel that I wanted, but now I wanted to. Oh, I had one more that I didn't have the time to fill up. Oh, some buggy. Animation bugged out there. I just wish I knew. Remember where the lighter was. So where was the lighter? Ah, as if it wasn't stressful enough without the alarms going off on my mobile phone that I'm using as a camera. Okay, let's see. I really want to use the... Oh, I found it. But our friend might be popping out for a surprise visit. Grenade. Me like. Your odd was 10:53. Molotov cocktails. Shit. So if I can, if he comes in here, I can loop around, I think. Yeah, he went into another room. Did he get there so quickly though? Did he not follow me? He wants to have the final showdown as well. Now we save. And now we can craft Molotov cocktails. A couple of them I think could be useful. Bring that one. Then we can skip these. Bring that one. Bring the bunny. Need a lighter. Skip that one. Of course the shotgun, and yeah, we need shotgun shells. I have one. Soon we'll have more. 25 or 2. He's out. He's coming in here, right? Yeah. Oh shit, shit, shit. He's really aggressive at the end of the game. Okay, do I have everything I want? I can skip this. I need to do some inventory cleaning up. Oh, I only have 2 bullets? What the? Okay. And then this one, 2 shells. Okay, then we have a grenade, we have those things, now we're done. We can go for the final showdown. Yee! So here's where what I was basically saying earlier. Our wish was to make an ending where you're actually having to use all of the skills you've learned so far. So, for example, breaking wood is a good knowledge to have, that you can do that with, for example, the shotgun or a grenade or whatever. And all this area now is like it's old, ancient arena, basically. And all of these bridges you see here, they are randomized for every time you enter this level. So basically, need to kind of scout the area first to start and understand where are the wooden bridges, which bridges are possible to raise like that. You saw that there's a wooden bridge over there that's broken already. And here comes our friend. Oh shit, I didn't hook this up. So, is he coming? Should be. Yep. Oh, so I managed to actually throw that grenade perfectly so that he fell down into the rift beneath. Now everything is crumbling, so you need to be fast and avoid standing on a wooden bridge when it's breaking. Yeah, that was a bit chaotic. I didn't want that ending actually, but you get what you want. You get what you get. And eventually, of course, you manage to get out with some lag again into the fresh, open, war-tainted air. And that's it. I played it through. What more can I say about this game? I mean, it's a game where we try and put the player in behind the driving wheel, setting up a bunch of rules and frameworks that are dynamic and random. The monster has very few scripted behaviors, like scripted encounters. It all comes down to what you are making in this game, what your actions are, how loud you are, and eventually it becomes this kind of sandbox where I think I've seen so many playthroughs of this game now, and I've seen so many different, unique, individual war stories where people basically have situations that no one else had. And that's super fun to see, because that's been the idea behind basically every mechanic fuels that type of situation. So whenever you throw a grenade at a door or trigger a trap or get a rat to start following you because you're bleeding or you get too close to the rats, and how you need to, we put obstacles out there in the environment for the player to have to encounter and want to encounter, instead of them following you, you would like to approach them. The same goes with the corpses. They have dog tags, they are useful to you, but the rats, of course, they are there as well, and they are the ones you need to manage. And then we have tons of different smaller mechanics like gas grenades, gas mask, fuel you can pour on the floor, set fire to, things you can craft. It all comes down to that type of balance in this game, where everything focuses around you. So some people say, of course, this game has maybe not as much, let's say, voice acting, characters, and story in a way. And this is our experiment where we wanted to see if we can really make the game about you. Even though you're playing Henri Clément, it's really about you and your experience fully. So in other games, maybe you and another player can talk about the situation and it was pretty much exactly the same. I mean, if you compare them, there's not much of a difference. Here, there's hopefully tons of different situations that you can share with each other and find out that they are pretty unique to you. That has been the goal of this game, and of course to make it as scary as possible. I'm gonna go to bed now. I hope you enjoyed this playthrough. I had fun actually, and I finished it in, let's see when we come to the stats page. Hold RT to skip. Now I'm doing that. Yeah, here we go. So it was basically shell shock difficulty, but with a big difference that I did not have the saving cost fuel, which would have been horrible to try and finish it in 2 minutes and 36 seconds. That's not paused time, didn't pause that much, so it must have been something like that. You can check the length of the video afterwards. I saved quite a lot. I had I died 3 times and I got scared many times. I didn't think I would get scared that many times actually, but still this game makes me jump. And you saw my a couple of those deaths that I had was really out of nowhere, and it made me jump. So I hope you enjoyed this little playthrough and some of the commentary. Here's my difficulty settings. And I hope you, if you haven't already played the game, I hope you want to do that. It's a game that should, in my opinion, be played, maybe not watched. So if you watched it all the way through this video, you've done it wrong. We have some other fun stuff, just can show you quickly before we end. This training grounds menu is something that, menu option is something that pops up after you've finished the game once. And it's just to hone your skills. I mean, just go in here, play around as much as you want with the different mechanics. Actually gonna go over here as well and bring, here you have the firing range. You get a gun, you get the gun, and tons of bullets. I can actually put that one on. Yeah. Just go in here, have fun, practice firing the gun. There's also other areas, like here we have grenade practice. Pick up a couple of those. Let's see. Practice how the grenade rolls so you don't throw it too far. And then, of course, firing range. Yes. Okay, let's get this done right. And I still didn't get those down that I aimed for, so let's do another one. Just for fun. Physics! Where did I put... Yeah, I put it here. Did I have any bullets left? As you see, it's just a little training course and some other things. We put a timer there for you so you can try and better your record. So, yeah, but that's it for this playthrough, I think. As I said, hope you enjoyed it. I did. And hope to see you in the bunker soon. Bye now.